In this video, we will derive the Bernoulli equation. It describes how a liquid flows, for instance, through a pipe with varying cross-section. But it can also be used to describe the laminar flow of gases at not too high velocities. First, think about the intuition here. When the cross-section gets more narrow, still the same amount of liquid should pass through the pipe. So the smaller the cross-section, the faster the flow. This acceleration implies a higher kinetic energy at places with small cross-section compared to places with a large cross-section. On the contrary, the pressure is higher at places with a large cross-section. But if that's not obvious, just consider the following derivation. We will make two assumptions. First, energy conservation. So the sum of kinetic energy and potential energy is constant. And second, the liquid is incompressible. Let's now consider the situation that the liquid flows through a pipe of varying cross-section. At some cross-section A1, the potential energy, or work, done by the flow is given by the force times the displacement along the same direction. So delta W1 equals F1 times delta X1. We can express the force as a product of the pressure P1 onto a surface, that is the cross-section A1. Then the combination of the cross-section and the displacement delta x1 is a volume element, delta v1. So the work done by a flow of fluid is pressure times the volume element. Next, we can write down the kinetic energy. It is mass times velocity squared over 2. The mass should be written as the density times the same volume element that we used before for the potential energy. Because of energy conservation, the sum of these two energy contributions is constant. Now, the same argument can be repeated for a different cross-section A2. And the sum again yields the same constant total energy. Because we assume the liquid to be incompressible, the densities rho 1 and rho 2 are actually equal and we can simply write rho. The same holds for delta V1 and delta V2. The volume of an incompressible fluid cannot be compressed. This further simplifies the equation and we arrive at the Bernoulli equation. When we set the flow velocity V equals 0, the total pressure P0 is reached. This is a conserved quantity of the system. The pressure P, on the other hand, is called static pressure on the flowing liquid. The difference of the total pressure and the static pressure is called dynamic stagnation pressure and equals rho times V squared over 2. That's pretty much it for this video. Thanks for watching!